friends, welcome back to Relief Tutorials. Today we are going to learn long division method, which we have already learned in 9th standard and 8th standard. Now see, this is the polynomial p of x. It is divided by linear polynomial x minus 1. Now, one thing is necessary, is this p of x is divided by x minus 1. So this is a dividend, this is divisor. Degree of dividend should be greater than degree of divisor. Now, you know that how to divide this. So you will take the first term of this dividend, p of x, x raised to 4. And you have to take the first term of this divisor, x minus 1. You divide both this. So x raised to 4 divided by x is equals to x cubed. This x cube you have to write here on the top, x cube. Okay, first term of dividend divided by first term of divisor, whatever the answer you will get, you have to write here on the top. Now, this x cube has to be multiplied with both the term of divisor. So, x cube into x, so you will get x raised to 4. X cube into minus 1, so you will get here minus x cube. Then you have to subtract this. So when you subtract this x raised to 4 minus x cube from this polynomial, the sign of both the term will change. This way, subtract x raised to 4 minus x cube. You are subtracting from this p of x. So when you open the bracket, what happened here? Minus x raised to 4 and plus x cube. So the sign plus will become minus and this minus will become plus. So sign of each term will change. So I will change the sign here. This will become minus and this will become plus. Now x raised to 4 minus x raised to 4. So this will get cancelled. Now x cube plus x cube. So you will get here 2x cube. Rest of the term you will write as it is. Minus 2x squared plus x plus 1. Clear? Now, the same process has to be done here. Now, which is the first term here? 2x cubed divided by first term of a divisor, that is x. So, you will get here 2. X cubed upon x, so x will get cancelled. So, what will be left here? X squared plus 2x squared. That you have to write here again. Plus 2x squared. Same process now. Multiply this 2x squared with both the term of divisor. 2x squared into x, so 2x cubed. Always the first term will be same and it has to be get cancelled. Plus 2x squared minus 1, so you get here minus 2x squared. Now subtraction. So when you subtract this polynomial from this polynomial, the sign of each term will get changed. Here minus and here you get plus. So again the first term will get cancelled. Now minus 2x squared plus 2x squared. So this also will get cancelled. What is left here? X plus 1. Again, same process you have to start. This x divided by first term of divisor upon x, you get 1 plus 1. So you write here plus 1. Now 1 into x, x. 1 into minus 1, minus 1. Again, the sign will change. Here minus, here plus. So this will get cancelled. 1 plus 1. So 2 is a reminder. Clear? Now see, what we have p of x? P of x is x raised to 4 plus x cubed minus 2x squared plus x plus 1. And I will find here p of 1. See, I will explain why only p of 1. Why not p of 2? Why not p of 3? Why not p of minus 2? So 1. So in place of x, I will write 1. So 1 raised to 4 plus 1 cube minus 2 into 1 square plus 1 plus 1. Here, now 1 raised to 4, 1. 1 cube is 1. Here, minus 1 square is 1. 1 into 2 minus 2 plus 1 plus 1. So you get 2. Plus 2 minus 2 cancel. 2. Now remainder is 2. Here also we got remainder 2. So, moral of the story is that instead of doing such a long method in order to find remainder, this method will be quite helpful. But questioner asks, sir, why p of 1 only? So this is our reminder P of 1. And 2 is the value of a reminder. P of 1 is a reminder and value of reminder is 2. So why P of 1? Why not P of 2? Why not P of 3? Why not P of minus 2? Why not P of minus 1? Why only P of 1? Answer to this question is our reminder theorem. Okay? See, we'll do one more problem.
I will take one P of x. X square minus 5x plus 8. Okay? And g of x, that is divisor, is equals to x minus 2. So you divide here. X square minus 5x plus 8. And we are dividing with x minus 2. So as usual, first term is here x square. First term of divisor is x. X square upon x. So answer will be x. That I will write here x. X into x. So that is x square. X into minus 2. That is equals to minus 2x. Again, I will change the sign. I will write here minus, I will write here plus, this will get cancelled. Minus 5x plus 2x is minus 3x plus 8. Clear? Now first term of this minus 3x divided by first term of divisor, x answer will be minus 3. I will write here minus 3. Clear? Now minus 3 into x, so minus 3x, see here first term will be same. Minus into minus plus, 3 2s are 6. I will write here plus 6. Change the sign here plus here minus. This will get cancelled. 8 minus 6, remainder is 2. Again, you know that P of x is x square minus 5x plus 8, and I will write P of 2. So 2 square minus 5 2s are plus 8, 4 minus 10 plus 8, 8 plus 4 12, 12 minus 10 is 2. So the value of remainder is 2. But why P of 2? Once again the question arises. So one thing I want to make you clear here is this a viable method to find the remainder, or this is the viable method to find the remainder? Here, see here it is divided by x minus 1, so I have taken P of 1. Here it is divided by x minus 2, so I have taken P of 2. So, moral of the story is that, see, I will rub this. Moral is this, P of x, here it was divided by x minus 1, then remainder was, here remainder. Remainder was P of in this case, the polynomial P of x was divided by x minus 2, the remainder was P of 2. So, how you have to find whether P of 1 is remainder, P of 2 remainder? How it comes to know? Here, value of remainder in both the cases you have matched, it was 2. How we got that? Why P of 1 and why P of 2? So, here it is divided by x minus 2 here. See, it is divided by x minus 2, the remainder is P of 2. How? Just you have to suppose. Okay, x minus 2 is equals to 0. You have to suppose that x minus 2 is equals to 0. So, x is equals to 2. So, in place of x, I have written 2. So, it means when it is divided by x minus 2, the remainder is P of 2. Okay, in place of x, I will write 2. So, in place of x, I will write 2. So, remainder is P of 2. And this is the value of remainder. Don't get confused. When I say remainder, you have to say P of 2. And when I say value of remainder, so that is equals to 2. Here also in this case, you know this polynomial was divided by what? It was divided by x minus 1. So x minus 1. So x minus 1 equal to 0. So x is equals to 1. So remainder is, in place of x, I am writing 1. So remainder is P of 1. So remainder is P of 1. And value of remainder is 2. So this is remainder. And this is value of remainder. Got friends? Similarly, see if I say any polynomial P of x is divided by x plus 3, then what will be the remainder? So I told you x plus 3. So what you will suppose? X plus 3 equal to 0. So x is equals to minus 3. So x is minus 3. So in place of x you will write minus 3. So P of minus 3. Similarly, if I say p of x divided by x minus half, then what will be the remainder now? The remainder will be p of x minus half. So you write here x minus half is equals to 0. So x is equals to half. So remainder is p of half. In short, if it is minus 1, you will get 1. If it is minus 2, you will get 2. If it is plus 3, you will get minus 3. If it is minus half, you will get plus half. Similarly, if I say any polynomial p of x is divided by x minus a, then what will be the remainder? The remainder will be p of a, x minus a is equals to 0. So x is equals to a. So in place of x, you will write a. So remainder is p of. Have you got it? See here, x plus 3 is divided by. So you x plus 3 is equals to 0. So x is equals to minus 3. This is not the remainder, minus 3. Remainder is p of minus 3. In place of x, you have to write minus 3. So remainder is p of minus 3. As you have told here, it is divided by x minus 2. So x minus 2 is equals to 0. So x equal to 2. So 2 is not the remainder actually. P of 2 is the remainder. And value of remainder here, fortunately, it is 2. Have you got it, friends? So, in short, what you have to remember is this thing. Clear? See, this is the case. Now, same problem, this x square minus 5x plus 8 is divided by x minus 2. So I told you it is divided by x minus 2. It is divided by x minus 2. So remainder is p of 2. So this p of 2 is remainder. Have you got it? That is called remainder theorem. Now, if I want to write what is remainder theorem definition, so I can write that. Remainder theorem. If a polynomial, here you have to write degree greater than or equal to 1. The degree of that polynomial, dividend polynomial here, say this is the dividend polynomial, degree should be greater than or equal to 1. Degree greater than or equal to 1 is divided by linear polynomial. Divided by linear polynomial x minus a. So this polynomial p of x is divided by linear polynomial x minus a. Condition, degree of this polynomial should be greater than or equal to 1. It is divided by x minus a. Then remainder is p of a. This is called remainder here. Very simple. When a polynomial p of x of degree greater than or equal to 1 is divided by linear polynomial x minus a, then remainder is p of a. So this is remainder theorem. Clear? Now see, same I will just change here. I will write here 6. Write here 6. Now I will divide this polynomial. Say I will write here 6. Okay? So I will divide this polynomial. X square minus 5x plus 6 divided by x minus 2. So first term is x square divided by divisor. Here first term of divisor x. So you will get x. You will write here x. You will multiply this x with both the term. X into x, x square. X into minus 2, minus 2x. So you will cancel this. Change the sign. Cancel minus 5x plus 2x minus 3x plus 6. 8 you will not get here. Here you will get plus 6. Clear? Now, minus 3x divided by x is minus 3. I will write here minus 3. Minus 3 into x minus 3x. Minus into minus plus. 3 to that 6. So I will get 6 here. Now this also will get cancelled. So remainder will be 0. So here what is remainder? 0. You might be knowing that. See, if I divide 8 by 3. Then you will get 3 to the 6. And here remainder is 2. But same 8, if it is divided by 4, you will get 4 to the 8, and the remainder is when you will get remainder 0? When any number is divided by its divisor, multiple, factor. You know 4 is a factor of 8. So when 8 is divided by 4, divisor will be 0. Here you know 3 is not a factor of 8. So when this 8 is divided by 3, remainder is not equal to 0. So one thing is clear, when any number is divided by its factor, the value of remainder is 0. So here in our case, remainder is 0. It means it is divided by x minus 2. So we can say x minus 2 is a factor of this polynomial. Have you got it, friends? Value of remainder is 0. See here. Same example you take. Many other examples you can take. See, for example, 15. 15 divided by 3. So 3, 5 are 15 and remainder is 0. Why? Because this 3 is a factor of 15. Naturally, we know that 3 is a factor of 15. 3, 5 are 15. So when any number is divided by its factor, so value of remainder is 0. Same thing here, this polynomial is divided by x minus 2 and value of remainder is 0. So we can say this x minus 2 is a factor of this polynomial. So when any polynomial is divided by its factor, the value of remainder is always 0. See, now we'll see. Now this polynomial p of x is divided by x minus 2. So according to our remainder theorem, if any polynomial p of x is divided by x minus 2, then you know that the remainder is p of 2. So we'll find here remainder is p of 2. So we'll write 2 square minus 5 into 2 plus 8. Sorry, here we have to take polynomial 6. X square minus 5x plus 6 here it is. Okay, this polynomial is divided by x minus 2. So according to remainder theorem, polynomial is divided by x minus 2. The remainder is p of 2. So remainder is p of 2. So p of 2 means here you get 6. So 4 minus 10 plus 6. 6 plus 4, 10. 10 minus 10, 0. See. So value of remainder is 0. Remainder is p of 2. But value of remainder is 0. So from this we can say factor theorem. So we will write one more theorem, that is factor theorem. See, what is factor theorem? So these two theorems are very important. Factor theorem. What you can say? X minus A is a factor of P of X. Change in degree greater than or equal to 1. So x minus a is a factor of p of x only. When remainder p of a is equals to 0. See here, I told you x minus 2 is a factor of this polynomial p of x. When remainder p of 2, why? Because it is divided by x minus 2. So remainder is p of 2 and the value of remainder is 0. Okay, see here, p of x, here it was divided by x minus 2. So according to remainder theorem, remainder is p of 2. Here this remainder is p of 2 and value of p of 2 is 0. P of 2 is 0. So you can say x minus 2 is a factor of p of x. Have you got it? Same thing here. We can say polynomial p of x when divided by x minus a, remainder is p of a. And if value of remainder is 0, then you can say this x minus a is a factor of p of x. Same thing here. If p of x is divided by x minus 1, the remainder is p of 1. And if value of remainder of p of 1 is equal to 0, then you can say this x minus a is a factor of p of x. Have you got it, friends? So here everything comes here in this table. Have you got it? So what is remainder theorem and what is factor theorem? So first, please remainder theorem. When any polynomial p of x is degree greater than or equal to 1 is divided by linear polynomial x minus a, divided by linear polynomial x minus a, then according to remainder theorem, remainder is p of a. And if value of remainder is 0, then you can say x minus a is a factor of p of x. See here. If a polynomial degree greater than or equal to 1 is divided by linear polynomial x minus a, then remainder is p of a. Factor theorem, we can say x minus a is a factor of p of x. Then if and only if this I double F means if and only if remainder. So p of x is divided by x minus a, then remainder p of a is equals to 0.
So you can learn both the theorems simultaneously. Very easy. First you have to learn remainder theorem, then you have to say factor theorem. Here, see, once again I am going to remind. This polynomial x square minus 5x plus 6 is divided by x minus 2. Then according to remainder theorem, remainder is p of 2. And if value of p of 2 is 0, then you can say x minus 2 is a factor of p of x. Clear? You know how to find the factors here. See, I will write this. See, we'll check whether factor is. We'll find the factor of x square minus 5x plus 6. See, you know, x square minus 5x plus 6. So you find the factor of 6. The factor of 6 are 3 and 2. 3 2s are 6. Here the sign is minus. So you do this sign to the bigger number, minus 3. Here, now minus 3. What should I do with this 2? So I get minus 5. So I have to write minus 2 only. Why? Minus 3 minus 2 is equals to minus 5. Minus into minus is plus, and 3 into 2 are 6. So when you multiply these 2, you should get plus 6. And when you add these 2, you should get minus 5. So I will write here x square, splitting the middle term. So I will write minus 3x minus 2x plus 6. So I will take x common. So x minus 3. Here minus 2 common in this 2. So you will get x minus 3. Minus 2 into x minus 2x. Minus into minus plus 2, 3 is 6. Now from this 2 common is x minus 3, and what is left? X minus 2. So these 2 are the factors of x square minus 5x plus 6. So we can say x minus 2. See, x minus 2 is a factor of this polynomial. And see, answer x minus 3. That is our question. When you multiply these 2, once again you will get this polynomial. So this is a factor. X minus 2 is a factor. So if you want to check whether this x minus 2 is a factor of this polynomial or not, you have to divide this with x minus 2, and if value is remainder 0, then you can say x minus 2 is a factor. But this is a long method. Instead of doing this, we can use remainder theorem and factor theorem. This polynomial is divided by x minus 2. So polynomial p of x is divided by x minus 2. The remainder is p of 2. So you have found out p of 2. And if value of remainder is 0, then you can say x minus 2 is a factor. So you have to check both ways. See here. If it is plus 1, then n is equals to 0. Remainder p of 1 is equals to 0. Then if it is plus 1, so you can say x minus 1. If it is plus 2, you can say x minus 2. If it is minus 3, you can say x plus 3 is a factor. If it is plus half, you can say x minus half. If it is plus a, you can say x minus. Have you got it, friends? Both vice versa you have to understand. So if it is divided by x minus 1, remainder is p of 1. If it is divided by x plus 3, remainder is p of minus 3. And if p of minus 3 is 0, then you can say x plus 3 is a factor. If p of 2 is equals to 0, then you can say x minus 2 is a factor. If here it is plus, here it is minus. If here it is minus, here it is plus. Have you got it, friends? So this is remainder theorem and factor theorem. So please, you have to note down this table. You have to write the definition of this remainder theorem and factor theorem, and at the same time you see this is the case. So please copy it down, whatever I have done today on the board. Now one more thing. See, I am going to run this. Once again I am going to talk CDC. If any polynomial p of x is divided by x plus half, the remainder is p minus half, the remainder is p of half. If it is divided by x plus 3, the remainder is p of minus 3. Plus 3, minus 3. Minus 2, plus 2. And if value of remainder is 0, then we can say this is a factor of p of x. So please note down the whole table in a proper way. Have you got it? So we have learned what is remainder theorem, what is factor theorem. 10th class students, we have already done this in 9th standard. It is for to recap all these things. I have done it. Okay? So I am going to have this now. See, one more thing. If I say 13 divided by 2. So 2, 6 are 12 and the remainder is 1. So this is called dividend. This is called divisor. This is called quotient.
This is called remainder. Okay, dividend is called P of x, for example. Divisor is called G of x. This is called Q of x, quotient. Remainder is called R of x. So if you see this 13, how you will get 13 is equals to 2 into 6. 2 into 6 plus 1. 2 into 6, 12, 12 plus 1, 13. So this dividend, so I can say this dividend is equals to 2. 2 is divisor into 6. 6 is quotient into quotient plus 1. 1 is remainder. Clear, friends? So this 13, how you got? 2 into 6, 12 plus 1. So divisor into quotient plus remainder. So divisor into quotient plus remainder. In case of polynomial, you can write this dividend, you can write P of x is equals to divisor, you will write G of x into quotient, you will write Q of x plus remainder, that is R of x. So this is the case. Divided P of x is equals to G of x into Q of x plus R of x. You got it, friends? So this is the case. So just note it down. Now I am going to have this. Now we'll do few problems which will be helpful to you in MCQ and all these things. Find k if x raised to 51 plus 2x raised to 60 plus 3x plus k is divisible, is exactly divisible, divisible by x plus 1.
See, I told you by long division method you can find remainder. But here it will be impossible. You look at the polynomial, yeah? The degree of polynomial is 60. So how you can divide this by x plus 1 by long division method? And you have to find the value of k. So it is exactly, this polynomial is exactly divisible by x plus 1. Exactly divisible by x plus 1 means it is a factor of, this x plus 1 is a factor of this. Exactly divisible means remainder will be 0. Here it is mentioned, it is divisible. I can say, no, here if you know that, okay, 16 is exactly divisible by 8, 8 to the 16, so 16 is divisible by 8, so when this number is divisible by 8, remainder will be 0 always. So here it is mentioned that, okay, this polynomial is divisible by x plus 1, so I can say this is P of x, so here P of x is exactly divisible by x plus 1, then according to remainder theorem, this remainder. According to remainder theorem, remainder will be, it is divisible by x plus 1. So remainder will be P of minus 1. Have you got it, friends? This polynomial P of x is divisible by x plus 1. So it is divisible by x plus 1. So according to remainder theorem, remainder will be P of minus 1. And it is exactly divisible, means the value of this remainder will be 0. So this is main thing which you have to remember. No need of mentioning this, you can write in your rough work also. Now, so remainder is P of x is x raised to 51 plus 2 x raised to 60 plus 3 x plus 8. So remainder is, then you know, remainder is P of minus 1 and that is equals to 0. So this is P of x. We want to find P of minus 1. So wherever there is x, I will write minus 1. See, minus 1 raised to
of minus 1, this is p of x. I am finding p of minus 1, as we have seen, p of minus 1. So in case of x, I will get minus 1 here also. So that will be minus 1 raised to 51 plus 2 into minus 1 raised to 60 plus 3 into minus 1 plus k. This is p of minus 1, and that is equal to 0. So I got an equation, so I can find a known value k. In order to find any unknown value, you require equation. Minus 1 raised to 51, this is odd power. You know that if minus 1 raised to 3, it means minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. Minus into minus plus, plus into minus, minus. So wherever there is odd power, if I say minus 1 square, so minus 1 into minus 1. Minus into minus plus, 1 into 1, 1. So when there is an even power, you will get plus sign. When there is an odd power, you will get minus sign. Wherever there is minus. Clear? So here also the same thing. Minus 1 raised to 51, so you will write minus 1. Minus 1 raised to 60, even power. Even power means positive 1. So 1 into 2, 2. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. Plus k is equal to 3. So now, minus 3, minus 1, minus 4. Minus 4 plus 2. So minus 2 plus k is equal to 0. So k is equal to 2. So here the value of k is equal to 2. So some problem you can't do by long division method. Okay. You have to follow default, you have to follow this remainder theorem and factor. I hope you understood this problem. We will discuss few more problems here. Remainder of polynomial p of x I plus dx minus 2x squared plus ax cubed when divided x minus 2 is twice the remainder when it is divided by x plus 1. Show that 10a plus 4b is equal to 9.
Yeah, read the question. The remainder of p of x, this is our polynomial. This polynomial when divided by x minus 2, when it is divided by x minus 2, whatever the remainder you obtain is twice the remainder when the same polynomial is divided by x plus 1, and you have to show this. Clear? So now you see, here our polynomial p of x, when it is divided by x minus 2, then you know according to remainder theorem, when polynomial p of x is divided by x minus 2, so I told you x minus 2 equal to 0, so x equal to 2, so you write here 2. So remainder is p of 2. Same thing when this polynomial p of x is divided by x plus 1, then remainder is, it is divided by x plus 1, so x plus 1 equal to 0, so x equal to minus 1, so you write here minus 1. Remainder is p of minus 1. I told you when it is minus you will get plus, when it is plus you get minus, so both are this remainder. Clear? No need of showing this, but just for your understanding I am writing all these things. Clear? Now, so when this polynomial p of x is divided by x minus 2, the remainder is p of, so you write that. When p of x is divided by x minus 2, remainder is p of 2. So p of x is 5 plus dx minus 2x squared plus ax cubed. So remainder p of 2, 5 plus b into 2 minus 2 into 2 squared plus a into 2 cubed. In place of x, I have substituted 2. 5 plus 2b minus 2 squared is 4. 4 to the 8 plus
2 cube is 8, 8 plus 8k. So here what I will get? 8a plus 2b, 8a plus 2b, 5 minus 8, 5 minus 8 is minus 3. So this is remainder. Clear? Same now, p of x is divided by x plus 1. The remainder is directly added, right? Remainder p of minus 1. So this is p of x. In place of x, we have to write minus 1. So what do you write? 5 plus b into minus 1 minus 2 into minus 1 square plus a into minus 1 cube. Clear? So you write 5 minus b minus 1 square is 1. 1 into minus 2 minus 2. Minus 1 cube is minus 1 into a. So that is just 2 minus a. So 5 minus 2, 5 minus 2 is 3, minus b minus a. This is our relation. So we have find the remainder when this polynomial is divided by x minus 2, remainder is p of 2. So you find the remainder p of. When this polynomial is divided by x plus 1, you know remainder is p of minus 1. So you have found p of minus 1. Now what is the result given here? Result is that, okay, the remainder of this p of x when divided by x minus 2 is twice. So remainder is twice the remainder obtained when this polynomial is divided by x plus 1. So this remainder is twice this remainder. So I can say here now 8a plus 2b minus 3 is equals to this is twice of this. So that is equals to 2 into 3 minus b minus a. Have you got it, friends? See this remainder. This remainder is twice this remainder. So it is double than this. If I multiply this with 2, both will become equal. So what I will get here? 8a plus 2b minus 3 is equals to 2, 3 is 6 minus 2b minus 2. So on a over one side. So 8a plus 2b is 8a plus 2b as it is. Minus 2b comes here. So plus 2b. Minus 2a comes here. Plus 2a. Is equals to here 6 and this minus 3 goes here, so plus 3. All a and b on one side. 8a plus 2a, so that is 10a. Plus 2b plus 2b, that is 4b. 6 plus 3, 9. So we got 10a plus 4b is equals to 9. 10a plus 4b is equals to 9. So, have you got it? So this type of problems will be asked, so you will be able to. One last problem we'll do. So here p of x is given. So this when divided by x plus 1 use remainder. Find a. Also find the remainder when p of x is divided by x plus 2. So look here. This is polynomial, when divided by x plus 1, use remainder 90. So here see, this polynomial p of x is divided by x plus 1, then according to remainder theorem, remainder is p of minus 1, not minus 1, I told you, p of minus 1. X plus 1 equal to 0, so x is equals to minus 1. So this minus 1 you have to substitute here, so you will get p of minus 1. Okay, and value of remainder, this is remainder, but value of remainder is 90. So p of minus 1 is equals to 90. Clear friends, according to remainder theorem, see here, once again I am going to repeat, this polynomial p of x is divided by x plus 1, then according to remainder theorem, you know remainder is p of minus 1, but the value of remainder is 19, so remainder is equals to 19. So we got an equation. So with this equation, we can find a known value. See, now p of x is remainder is p of minus 1, that is equals to 90. So you will find p of minus 1. So what you will get? Minus 1 raised to 4, 2 into minus 1 cube, 3 into minus 1 square, minus a into minus 1, plus 3a minus 7 is equals to 90. So I have found out p of minus 1, and that is equals to equal to 19. Minus 1 raised to 4 is 1. Minus 1 cube is minus 1, minus 1 into minus 2 plus 2, minus 1 square is 1, 1 into 3 plus 3, minus into minus plus, here a plus 3a minus 7 equal to 9. Now 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 3, 6, 6 minus 7, so you will get minus 1, and 3a plus 8, so that is equals to 4a. Is equals to 19. So 4a is equals to minus 1 goes on once and 19 plus 1. So that you will get it 20. A is equals to 20 divided by 4. So a is equals to 5. So now you got the value of a. So you have to find a. So a is equals to 5. And also you have to find the remainder when p of x is divided by x plus 2. So that is the second part. Now the polynomial is divided by x plus 2. So you know when this is divided by x plus 2, remainder is x plus 2 equal to 0. X plus 2 is equals to 0. So x equals to minus 2. So you write here minus 2. The remainder is p of minus 2. But before that, you got the value of a. So you will substitute this a here in this equation. A. A here you will substitute 5x. Okay. Plus 3 into 5. 15. 15 minus 7. So that you do now see here. I love this. We got a. A is 5. A is 5. So first we will substitute a. So what we will get? X is 2 4 minus 2x cube plus 3x square minus a. A is 5. So minus 5. A is 5. A is 5. So 5x plus here a is 5. So 3 5s are 3 into 5 minus 7. 3 into 5, 15, 15 minus 7. So what you will get? X raised to 4 minus 2x cube plus 3x square minus 5x. 5 is a 15, 15 minus 7. So you will get plus 8. So this is our p of x now. Now this p of x is divided by x plus 2. So according to remainder theorem, remainder is p of minus 2. Clear or not? No need of writing this at all. You know it is divided by x plus 2, so remainder will be p of minus 2. Now I will find p of minus 2. See, p of minus 2. So here in place of x, minus 2 raised to 4 minus 2, x you get minus 2 cube plus 3 into minus 2 square minus 5 into x. X is minus 2, 5 into minus 2 and plus 8. So what do you get? Minus 2 raised to 4, so 16 minus r is even, so plus 16, minus 2 cube, so minus 8, minus minus plus, 8 to the 16, minus 2 square, 4, 4 3 is 12, minus minus plus, 5 to the 10, plus 8, 16 plus 16, 32, 32 plus 12, see 32 plus 12, we will get 44, 44 plus 10, so we will get 54, 54 plus 8, 54 plus 8, so you will get 62. So remainder is 62. Remainder is p of minus 2. Value of remainder is 62. You got it, friends? I hope you enjoyed this lecture. You have learned division, long division method. Then you have discussed remainder theorem. Then you have discussed factor theorem. And based on this theorem, I have explained few problems. Clear? Yeah. if they say check whether the polynomial as a factor 2t plus 1.
So we have to check whether this 2t plus 1 is a factor of this polynomial or not.
So now you see here, friends, 2t plus 1 equal to 0. So 2t is equals to minus 1. So t is equals to minus 1 by 2.
So I told you, what will be the remainder? This polynomial is divided by this 2t plus 1. So 2t plus 1 0, you imagine, then you got t minus half. So our remainder will be t of minus half.
You know that we have seen this polynomial t of t. T of t is divided by 2t plus 1. Then according to remainder theorem, remainder 2t plus 1 0. The remainder is t of t, and t is how much? Minus half. Remainder is t of minus half. And if value of remainder is equals to 0, then I can say this 2t plus 1 is a factor.
Have you got it, friends?
So this thing you have to do. Polynomial p of t is divided by 2t plus 1. So you have to suppose 2t plus 1 equal to 0. Find the value of t. Substitute this t here. So t of minus half is the remainder. And if the value of remainder is equal to 0, then only this is a factor. So you have to check here, remainder t of minus half is equal to 0 or not. So we have p of t here. What you will find? You will find p of minus half. And if value is 0, then this will be the factor. 4 minus half raised to q plus 4. Minus half square minus t. So t is minus half and minus 1. I have substituted t equal to minus half, that's all. So this is equals to 4 minus cube, so you will get minus 1, 2 cube, 8 plus 4 minus square plus 1 square, 1, 2 square, 4 minus into minus plus half and minus 1. Here now 4 ones are 2s are, so you will get minus half plus 4, 4 cancel, 1 plus half minus 1, minus half plus half cancel, plus 1 minus 1 cancel, 0. So therefore here I can say p of minus half is equals to 0. So therefore p of minus half is equals to 0. Therefore 2t plus 1 is a factor of p of t. So here we have this factor theorem. So this polynomial is divided by 2t plus 1. So you will suppose 2t plus 1 equal to 0. So t is minus half. So remainder is p of t. T is minus half. So remainder is p of minus half. And if value of remainder is equal to 0, then only this 2t plus 1 is the factor of p of t. So remainder p of minus half we have find out, and if value is equal to 0, so therefore we can say 2t plus 1 is the factor of p of t. I hope you enjoyed this lecture. What is remainder theorem and factor theorem? So please go through it and try to understand. Thank you very much.